Let's discuss with our friends here. David Urban, this is unprecedented. You don't have to defend it if you don't want to, but I've never heard of such a thing.
Listen, so yeah, it's unprecedented, but, you know, revoking of security clearances. I know this is a revoking of security clearances. These gentlemen have all been retired for quite some time. I think that it is a nicety that they're allowed to keep their clearances to be a part of the club as former directors. So the revocation of a security clearance at that level, I don't think it takes abuse or scandal or anything along those lines. I'm not quite certain why they're allowed to maintain them. I'm not really the
We're going to go to Barbara Starr, the Pentagon, to explain that in 1 second. But first, I do want to get everybody's reaction. Yeah. What do you think of the president?
Well, I mean, the thing is that he's not applying this equitably, obviously. It's only against people who have criticized him. So it's being used as a tool to try and silence people who are criticizing him, people who I've certainly had disagreements with, and I'm sure other people have had disagreements with, but who I think we all would agree are pretty patriotic individuals. They're people who some served in the military. They've held positions working for Republicans and Democrats. And so, you know, to make it out like it's not that big of a deal, it is a big deal when the president singles out people who are criticizing him, who are very reputable people in our country.
That list is heavy with one name on there, I think, is obviously much more critical than the others. I think, you know, Mike Hayden comes on and is not as harshly critical as Clapper is, right? I mean, you see, I think he is the shining.
But it's sort of a who's who of the enemies of, you know, Trump, of conservatives, of Fox News. And if you've looked at Fox News over the last couple of days, this is something they've been talking about too. Tucker Carlson, he brought this up specifically. Why does John Brennan still have his security clearance? Then Rand Paul jumps on it too. So it's clearly, you know, the president has been back on his heels in some ways, even on Fox News. So I think he's grabbed on to this idea that has been floating around among conservatives for a while. You hear from Clapper and the folks who have these kind of honorary clearances, it's not like they're going back for briefings every day. Susan Rice is on the board of Netflix at this point. I think she's moved on a bit from needing or even wanting a security.
Well, it's not going to pause on the idea that President Trump is opposed to the idea of people monetizing their government service. Right. If that is the case, perhaps you'd like to talk to your daughter, your son-in-law, your sons, and maybe Sean Spicer, who is promoting a book right now, which he has every right to do.
Come on.
He has every right to do that.
The most draconian lobbying
ban for any administration. Let's all take a minute to laugh at the idea that Trump is serious when he's saying he opposes that. But secondly, Brennan is being accused of divulging classified secrets. I'm not aware that that has happened. There's lots of people saying that. I am aware that he said the Putin meeting was treasonous, but you don't need classified briefings to form that opinion, although it's controversial.
Let me put that tweet up there. Brennan said last week about the president's behavior when he stood next to Vladimir Putin in Helsinki. He said, quote, Donald Trump's press conference performance in Helsinki rises to and exceeds the threshold of high crimes and misdemeanors. It was nothing short of treasonous. That, of course, is something I could certainly understand why President Trump would object to it. But the question is it appropriate to revoke his security clearance?
Yeah, I mean, that's an opinion, and these people have a right to an opinion, as controversial as it may be. And you saw that Clapper, when he spoke earlier on CNN, said, listen, I don't need these security briefings to go comment to the press. And so I would encourage those people to double down in the press, because this is a direct action aimed at silencing them. And if they feel strongly about it, they should speak
and
out.
Clapper called it an abuse of the system. But I want to go to Barbara Starr right now at the Pentagon to explain for us, because I think there is some confusion out there and at this table. Why do these officials even have security clearances? Is it a nicety? Why does this exist?
It is neither honorary or a nicety or some kind of protocol. Senior former officials in the intelligence and military community, like you said, General Flynn, retain these clearances so that they can be consulted by currently serving officials. Let's say there's a terror attack, an immediate crisis with North Korea, an immediate crisis with Iran, some kind of military contingency, a development with Al-Qaeda. You want to be able to go back to the former officials who dealt with these problems over the years and be able to talk to them in a classified setting. What did you know? How did you deal with the problem? Do you have any recommendations about it going forward? Given the amount of turnover in the Trump administration, it might be nationally, from a national security standpoint, rather valuable for Mr. Trump to retain these people, to have that ability to consult them. That's what this is all about. They don't go on TV and disclose classified information. They don't go trolling through files and computer disks. They don't even have necessarily a need to know. that would allow them to even get into classified information. It's very specific. So current officials can go back to former officials who have decades of experience in these critical matters in a crisis and say to them, how did you deal with it? What can we learn from you? That avenue now, it may be shut off. Jake?
All right, Barbara Starr, thanks so much. And I want to get the responses coming in from some of these officials. I want you to take a listen to a little clip from the former director of national intelligence under President Obama, James Clapper, reacting to this news.
If he chooses to do it for political reasons, well, I think that's a terrible precedent. It's a very sad commentary. And it's an abuse of the system.
And also, Michael Hayden, the former head of the CIA and NSA under President Bush, he's on a plane, so we can't have him on the show right now. But he did respond to a tweet of mine when I noted what had just happened. He wrote to me on Twitter, I don't go back for classified briefings, won't have any effect on what I say or write. So that's the reason.
Right, yeah, but so again, the notion that somehow the Trump administration is going to sit around and sing kumbaya with the officials from the Obama administration? It's farcical. It's
but
not going to happen.
If something happens,
why wouldn't they?
Because they have serious policy disputes with the folks. Okay,
but they have no knowledge that could be learned
Amanda,
from their experience.
Amanda, right? So you can go back in the way back machine to, you know, President Bush, the President Carter, pick somebody, right? Stan Turner, Zbigniew Brzezinski, you pick anybody, right?
Okay, but I just don't discount someone and their experience just because they vote for someone else.
I'm not discounting their experience. Mm-hmm. I'm making a statement. I doubt that this administration is going to sit down and take counsel from people who they have diametrically opposed opinions with.
That's incredibly damning.
I'm just saying.
Well, they can be surrounded by young
people. But that Obama's weren't sitting down with the Bushes.
Actually, that's not true.
Yeah, sure,
Obama's. Obama, you're telling me Barack Obama and George Bush never spoke?
No, it's the administration.
Or the idea officials. That there was never any communication. Look, they were talking about, what Barbara Starr was just talking about is a crisis. And the idea that in a crisis that no one would ever communicate with somebody that has experience, mm-hmm. I think is wrong. And the fact that you have some policy disagreements means you can never speak to each other, I think is very problematic. But look, I think as abuse of power is the right thing to call this. And what we see with Trump over and over is, we're learning a lot about our system, right? That the president can do this. It's just that no president ever did do this. And that's what happens over and over, that our system is predicated on the idea that you're going to be patriotic, that you're going to put the country before yourself and your petty little problems with other people, and that you're going to recognize that there are people that disagree with you. And you're not going to be okay with that by any measure, by the way.
So one of the things that one of the criticisms coming out right now is a spokesperson for Andrew McCabe, noting that McCabe doesn't even have the security clearances, suggested that this is just the White House trying to change the subject.
Sure.
Yeah. What are they trying to change the subject from? President Trump reiterating that he does not believe the intelligence. Let's just put up the tweet that's causing a lot of the attention today. So President Obama knew about Russia before the election. Why didn't he do something about it? Why didn't he tell our campaign? Because it is all a big hoax. That's why. And he thought Crooked Hillary was going to win. And the suggestion being made by Democrats and others is, look, President Trump's just trying to change the subject from the fact that he, again, doesn't believe the intelligence community and doesn't believe what pretty much everyone else in the country, except for the president and some people at a different network, think is true, which right. is that the Russians interfered in the election.
Yeah, I think that's true, that he's trying to change the subject. And you've seen him kind of do that over the last couple of days. The tweet about Iran seemed to be an attempt to change the subject in all caps, basically saying fire and fury is going to rain down on Iran if they keep, you know, smart-talking the U.S. Even the stuff about the Cohen leaks, the tapes from that seemed to be an attempt to change the subject. So this too, is in the same category. You saw Sarah Sanders loaded for bear there, mm-hmm. right? With that statement, with all of the names, you know, the most wanted names really on that list that she had. Didn't even do the research, right? Enough to know that Comey and McCabe didn't have security clearances anymore. So I do think they thought this was going to be a big bombshell. Everybody was going to, you know, react and maybe overreact.
And this is one of Trump's favorite things to do against his opponents, which is to dangle out something that he may do to them and keep that threat hovering over them, make them react, and then pummel them again. I mean,